Hi everyone, this is Arcadius and welcome back to Naval Creed. Today we will be going over the fourth mission for the current event right now. However, I was going back through my videos and it seems as though my recording for the second mission decided to stop recording video but kept recording audio. So I'm actually going to redo the second mission and then do the fourth mission. So let's hop right in. Again, we're going to use Illinois, and let's see what we can do today. Alright, so the second mission again was Kronstadt, Kirov, Krasny Kavkaz, Kavkaz, and to Leningrads. So, a lot of easy choices to do, at least with secondaries. Alright, and here we go. Alright, so the event so far has been pretty good. You're not able to get a lot of points. I mean, 180,000 points for the USS Halford. Not only, she better be worth it, honestly. I mean, if anything in regards to Aurora case, then the event ships for this one are actually relatively okay-ish. Like I said before, Aurora is pretty powerful, if not the most powerful Tier 2 ship in the game right now. So maybe Halford will have a similar capability. I highly doubt it, but she'll still be a fun ship to use, at least. Alright, so now we're just gonna start mopping up these Krasny Kavkazes. We can use our speed boost and head on our way. I use Grosser Kurfürst, or H-42, in the lightweight final mission earlier, just to see how effective it would be. It is actually a lot more effective than I ever thought. I did lose about half health, but I was able to take out the final boss relatively quickly, and then I just had the rest of the smaller bots to deal with, but those were no problem at all. So yeah, that definitely means that Grosser Kurfürst is a good option. So now we have Kirov's. Let's focus actually on this one. Now they all have torpedoes, so I need to try and keep my distance as much as I can, be unpredictable. Even though they're not really shooting at me. Let's see here. Yep, there's some torpedoes. Alright, so I need to focus on the ship I want. Here we go. One down. Alright, let me just... You don't really need to focus secondaries, honestly, but right now it'd be good just to... Oh, I actually took a torp. Interesting. Okay, I thought I was clear. You can see how the bots are not afraid to use torpedoes. Alright, so let's see what we can do against Kronstadt. Now, I took H-42 against this mission earlier as well. I used nothing but secondaries, and I was able to get sink like 7 out of all these ships with just secondaries, including the Kronstadt. So that was pretty funny. Alright, so now we're just mopping up the end of this mission. So this, like I said, this was just a re-recording since the other one seemed to be interrupted for whatever reason. I'm not sure why, but it's no biggie. This mission was a really quick one. However, the fourth mission, the one that we're going to do today after this one, is a bit of a challenge, but not so much that you would lose. But we'll get into that in a moment. We just have to finish up this real quick. As you can see, any ship with good secondaries, you don't really have to care about any of the targets. Actually, I should probably go on the right side, that way my secondaries on the left side can shoot the Kronstadt. Or at least, that would be the idea if she was still alive. Oh, also, so, I was able to get Veliki Novgorod, the top-tier Russian cruiser, and I have played a few games with her. She's actually not as bad as I expected her to be. I still have a lot to learn and see how she plays best, since she's just such a unique cruiser. However, she is very, very fun. So I will hopefully get a chance to show you all of that later on. Alright, so that was the second mission. 266,000 damage, 8 ships sunk, 62 shell hits, 6 citadels, 9 fires, 2 modules destroyed, 232 shell hits. Alright, and now for today's main course, Moon, question mark. Probes have spotted a swarm of man-made objects in close proximity to the moon's orbit. Create room. Let's go. So this one has an FDR, so the newest carrier. You have 3 Mikhail Kutuzovs, you have 4 Chapayevs, you have a bunch of Grozovoys, and 3 new Strashmis. So as you can see, there's a lot more at stake for the fourth mission than the fifth one, or at least the previous three. All right, so this is where you first start seeing that carrier. So this is the first mission that AA is actually important. Right, and then you have a bunch of destroyers showing up right in front of you. Even if there is a carrier, you could still use H-42 really, really nicely here, because the secondaries would be able to take care of everything. Your Hydro would be able to see the ships and smoke screens and detect the torpedoes. And her AA, though not the best, would be able to at least knock down a few planes. And then her main guns would either be used to completely annihilate the Russian cruisers and or use against the carrier, because the carrier actually spawns on the right side. So where I'm kind of aiming right now, that's where she will be. Or at least that's how it's been every time I play this level. Alright, so you try and get rid of these destroyers as quickly as possible, and try not to take any torps in the meantime. You don't really have to use your main guns if you don't want to. If you're in a good enough secondary ship, you shouldn't have to worry about it. As you can see, that this Grozovoy is just melting. It's always fun to watch. Alright, so now we have Mikhail Kutuzov. They're using the sap, which does do quite a bit of damage to your superstructure. However, they are still Russian cruisers and can be deleted quite easily if you lead your shells enough, as shown there. Ooh, we got a double strike. Triple strike? Yeah, triple strike. Alright, so here's the FDR's planes. Put my fighter in the air. I'm actually gonna have to use a heal because we took quite a bit more damage than I expected here. But we'll just go back to one-shotting cruisers. Knocking down some of the aircraft. one-shot another cruiser, hopefully. There we go. I know I make this look easy, but it really is just this easy. Russian cruisers, well, actually, I should say any cruiser that gives you full broadside to a battleship, is most definitely on the one-way ticket ride to back to port, because you just can't hold up to that kind of damage. Now remember, this is only 9 16-inch guns. When the Russian BB line comes out, the Katarina will have 16 16-inch guns, so almost a double of what I have right now. So when that ship comes out, oh man, will she be powerful. Also, now we're seeing the second wave, I guess you could say, of ships. I'm just one-shotting cruisers again. I'll pop another heal because those bombers from FDR are lighting me up quite easily. I didn't get all my shells across, but I was still almost able to sink that ship. Alright, so now we have the torpedo bombers from the FDR. Each plane drops 4 torpedoes. And our heals and our repairs almost done, so we have to take these before the flooding hits. Alright, so I think we're gonna have a flooding here. Maybe we could just take one. Just one? Yes, awesome. Okay. So let's take out this Chapaya. Then let's start focusing on this FDR. So let's do the FDR first, because the FDR is going to be the one that has the most chance of sinking us right now. And just let the secondaries do the work. Looks like FDR is going to run into the island, which makes our job a lot easier because now she's fully broadside. And we can get citadels on her as well. Not that I expect my fighter plane to survive very long, but anything to help break up those fighter squadrons and dive bomber squadrons will help me immensely. So there goes the carrier, and we just have 2 destroyers left, as which one is over here. Oh, and the other one's over there. Awesome. Those dive bombers are really good. Dive bombs on those ships is amazing, and here comes the torpedo bombers. So I'm waiting to use my heal, or repair I should say, until those come in. It looks like, there we go, we don't even have to worry about it. Awesome. Alright, so, oh wait, no, there's still one more? Alright, so I misread that, but that's fine. I can heal, at least repair. Put our fighter up again. And try and find out where this last destroyer is. While we're also gonna... there she is. We're gonna keep knocking down quite a few planes as well. And we should have our game in 3. Alright, okay. So, we didn't get that last kill, but that's fine. Let's see how we turned out. 428,000 damage, 13 ships sunk, 49 shell hits, 45 aircraft shot down, 15 citadels, 14 fires, 1 module destroyed, 411 secondary hits for over 6,000 base XP. 246,000 damage was in armor-piercing shells, 21,000 damage in fires, secondaries did 160,000 damage. I love this ship. Alright, so yes, you can easily see how having a high tier ship will do best. The fourth level is one where you, if you have a lower tier ship, you will suffer. If you don't have the health or AA to effectively deal with FDR, especially if you aren't able to take her out quickly. And then, I mean, with the Russian cruisers and destroyers, they're not that hard to destroy, especially the cruisers. As you can see, I was just one-shotting them left and right. And then I could just leave the destroyers to the secondaries. So either something like Illinois or any German battleship from Bismarck and above are probably the best options for you. However, that does not mean that that's all you have. Of course, you have Yamatos, you have Soyuz, you have with the British battleships. Anything you feel like you could use to the best of your ability to take on, what was it, like 14 ships? Yeah, so it's really what's best for you. However, Illinois is what works best for me. So, with that, I will wrap up today's video. And join me tomorrow while we go over the final mission, that is Forget Gravity. Now, that one is quite interesting. So, with that, again, thank you for watching, and take care.